Welcome back to my channel, Eating with MJ. Welcome back. And all you new subscribers, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for subscribing. Thanks for hitting that notification bell. Thank you. I appreciate it so much. Let's get started into the video because I'm so hungry. I really am starving. Today, what I have for you guys is a versus challenge. It's another, first of all, car mukbang, if you can already tell. But I have a versus challenge today. I have KFC, their $5 fill-up boxes. I know you guys, all you guys have seen these $5 fill-ups. I know you guys probably already went and you like the ones of your, you know, the one that you like best. They have a whole different bunch of varieties. And then also the Taco Bell $5 fill-ups, right? Now, let's get into this. Both meals were $5.33. $5, hence tax, you know, $5.33. Now, this is what Taco Bell, they change them. It's not the same like as in KFC. You get, you know, your choice of different varieties and it's always $5. No, Taco Bell, they changed them. And you got to see whatever one they have at the time, whatever $5 special they have. So far, KFC's winning. People like, you know, to have their pick, their choice, and not people tell them what their choices are. You know, people always like to pick and choose what they like. And once they like it, they like to have the opportunity to come back and get it. Here, if you like the chalupa box, which this is what it is, it's a chalupa box. You get your chalupa, right? You get two tacos. I don't know if you can see, guys. Well, I don't know. And then you get your dessert, which is the cinnamon twist, right? That's that. Let's get into our KFC box real quick. And then with KFC, you can either get like two pieces of chicken, you can get a pot pie, you can get a bowl. Like, they give you options. So far, KFC's winning. Now, your dessert is a chocolate chip cookie. And they always throw it in the box so it can get melty, yummy, gooey, delicious. I don't like that. So, my side, I normally get potato wedges, but today my stomach hurts. So I got, mashed potatoes and gravy. When you're hungry, your brain doesn't register things correctly. Wow, and guys, it's early. So I got their first batch of dropped chicken. This thing right here, look at that. I don't know, can you see how crispy and yummy this thing looks? Delicious. Okay, let's pray, guys. God is great, God is good, bless his food in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. I didn't get any hot sauce and honey today. Like I said, I'm not feeling well. Like, after this mukbang, I think I'm going to get into, like, bed and, like, go to sleep. Oh, yeah, and you get your drink. I got one, my coffee. And I normally get the Baja Blast, but I haven't had my caffeine today yet. And then a Pepsi. Did we pray? God is great. God is good. Bless this food. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Okay. And I noticed that KFC... Oh, yes. Okay. I'm about to say, they didn't give me a fork. I'm going to eat, like, the soft stuff first. But like I said, you know, and that's the hard part about being a mukbanger. Even if you don't feel good, the show must go on. Anyway. All right, guys. I also want to get into a little, you know, conversation with you guys. My last video did pretty well. I didn't know it was going to do that great. You know, at the end of the day, I was just talking. I was being myself. But then I realized, after I received so much love, you know what this is, mashed potatoes and gravy, and people's personal opinions of the matter of living with the Webbs. Like, first, I didn't know that they were that, you know, high in topic. I didn't know a lot of people disliked Olivia. I really didn't. Like, I was just going off of that morning. I woke up, I got on YouTube, and I saw there was so much stuff going back and forth. It was like between her and some girl named Chrissy or something like that. And then people just started flooding the comment boxes with what was actually going on, and it enlightened me, and I had to do my research and my homework basically on what was going on. And how many of you actually dislike Olivia? Wow, this is delicious. Oh, I felt it hit my stomach. So I like to think that there's always three sides to a story: yours, theirs, and the truth. So that's what I was looking for these past few days, the truth. I went onto Olivia's page, and I could see that her channel, and I could see, you know, where you guys dislike her at. I could see where she gets on your nerves a little. I could see all that, where some of it doesn't seem genuine. And I get it, you know. And then I noticed on other people's channels, basically, you know, some of them made videos about her being dishonest, about her, you know, not saying or doing and being truthful 100%, right? Now, I stand by what I say. Content is content. However or whatever you're doing that makes people click that button and they tune in and want to see what you're about, if it's real, fake, or whatever, in the beginning I was like, yeah, go for it, do it, you got to make money, you know, blah 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 blah. You got to find people, got to continuously be hustling. No matter what, you got to stay hustling. If you ain't got nothing, you better get up and go get something. And that's what I thought she was doing. She didn't have a job, so I figured she was out there collecting her YouTube coins. And however way, like, I saw some of the videos and I thought to myself, like, yeah, some of it's reality, some of it's scripted. You could basically tell. There was this one episode, she went and got a gun and pulled it on Gerard for some cheat and stuff. And I'm like, that seems scripted. I don't know how hood you are or from what gangster set you repping, but I've never seen somebody pull a gun on their significant other. And you could tell, like, that at that moment, it became that they were in that prank together. I like genuine pranks. Pranks where people are really pranking someone else versus two people in on the prank. It's not genuine. So, I mean, who's to say? I don't know. I'm not God. That could have been genuine. But from what it looked like, it didn't. So that's why I'm like, oh, I see what people are finally saying. It took you guys to open my eyes. I still love Olivia. Like, I feel like that guy from Britney Spears. Leave Britney alone. You guys remember, it was somebody Crockett or something like that. Leave Olivia alone. She's just trying to be great, guys. And I'm such, like, into supporting people. I'm like, hey, whatever works for her. Now, you guys don't like that. You're saying that maybe she's a fraud. Like, she's taking money from the government or extra food stamps. And I was laughing because I said, there was one comment that was like, oh, you know, some people sell their food stamps for dope, this. And I said, well, I have yet to see that. And you know what? I noticed that all her food stamps actually go to food. It actually, she like buys food for her kids and she eats and they eat. They're not for nothing, boo boo, but I know you just had a baby, but that body does not scream that you haven't been eating. You look like you've been eating. Like, and at the end of the day, that's good. So it's like, if she was some skinny girl and selling her food stamps and her babies were hungry, crying in the back saying, mom, let me get something to eat, please. And you see her doing all this, you know, okay, ratchetness, then I understand more. But like I said, at the end of the day, guys, we all gotta love each other. That, what's her name? Melisandre, you're awesome. I went on your channel and I saw all the positive things, all the who you are, and I just said, wow, she's great. Now, people try, you know, real quick, they try to like say, hey, no, you know, at the end of the day, she's ratchet, she's bad, she's this, she's that. And I'm like, okay, so be it. But she's still just like the rest of us trying to survive in this world. Have you guys noticed the price of what a gallon of milk cost? Like, okay, they're raising, what is it? What are they raising? The minimum wage. But guess what that means? They're also going to start raising prices on everything else in the world. They're like, oh, you're getting paid more money. Guess what? This costs more money now too. So it's like at the end of the day, people that are receiving or not receiving, the world is costly. So by all means, however way you get it. Now, like I was saying, Melisandre, your channel is awesome. I see that you do other things. And I noticed the videos about, you know, Olivia, and I realized that it's not that serious. It really is not that serious. I think Olivia made it serious by Xing out your channel, like giving you the X. At the end of the day, everyone's entitled to their own opinion. And you can unsubscribe or you can give somebody that X. You never gave Olivia an X. You kept subscribing to her. You kept watching her videos. You kept, you know, just looking at whatever you were looking at, and you just kept voicing your opinion. You never gave her an X and tried to stop her grind. She messed up and she tried to stop your grind by giving you an X. If you get three X's, I believe your YouTube channel is done. That's messed up. That to me said to me that Olivia isn't as good as I think she is. You know, like, you can't be such a great person and do bad things. You can't be an awesome person and do ugly things. Like, you just can't. That doesn't go hand in hand. So at the end of the day, I was just like, you know, that sucks. So that was like 1 point for Olivia. Then I'm like, okay, 1 point for you guys, because you guys just keep bashing her. But eventually that hate, that drama is gonna die down, because if you're a real YouTuber, your content is, it pertains to a bunch of other things as well. What I was talking about is that I actually came across some girl's channel. She only had 3 videos total on her channel, and they were all about Olivia. And I said to myself, why put so much time into uploading videos to decrease someone's value versus you supporting them? I'd rather support you than, you know, take away from you. And that's what Melisandre was doing for Olivia. She didn't like Olivia, but guess what? She was still watching. And with each watch time, that was still putting money in Olivia's pocket. And that's what one thing Olivia did not notice. And maybe she needs to realize that what she did was wrong. So yes, you know, in my last video, I was just talking about categorizing people in general, like with the whole hate. But when you look into deeper situation, you're like, whoa, this drama gets thicker. But I'm like, let's stop the beef. Let's eat chicken. Speaking of chicken, let's eat some chicken. Guys, look at this. Did I show you my chicken? I didn't even get into my Taco Bell box. Look at this. Because I'm like a KFC fan. Okay, the winner is KFC. I'm going to get into my box. They both give you desserts. They both give you a main dish. You both get a drink. I think they're both winning to me. It's just your choice of what you prefer. A meaty bite? Or, wow, a meaty bite. Okay, back to the situation at hand. Like I was saying, that was wrong. So that made me look at Olivia differently. Now, everyone's entitled to their own opinion, like I said, but guys, don't let it be your only opinion. Realize that we're all God's children. We all fall short of the glory. We're all not perfect. Olivia's not going to be perfect. I'm never going to be perfect. We're never going to be perfect. The only one that is perfect is him. You know who I'm talking about. Y'all know who I'm talking about. And at the end of the day, give, you know, glory to God that we're all here still. You know, he woke us up. We was all on the wake-up list, you know. I think, you know, Melisandre and Olivia should beef the drama. I believe that both of them are great people. You know, yes, I have my personal opinion. Some things, you know, but I'm not going to voice them. Why? Because it doesn't make or break the person or me. You know, like some, well, no. In Olivia's situation, it breaks her. She needs to learn how to take criticism. She needs to understand that at the end of the day, once you put your content out there, you're out there to be judged, for the world to look at you and see you and have their personal opinion about you. So you got to be ready. I say a hater's going to hate, boo-boo. We all got haters. You know, if you ain't hate on nobody, you might as well hate on me. Another one to the, you know, list of haters. Thank you. You know, but at the end of the day, okay, those haters shouldn't make or break you. If they break you, well, then you better give them one hell of a show. You better give them one hell of a show where they can't even say nothing about Olivia. And that's it. And just be happy in life. Be happy. And for all you guys that are just, you know, focusing on Olivia, guys, your car is going to run out of gas. Find something else. Or if that's what you do for your channel, find, you know, whatever else, collect your money. I'm all about everyone's gains. I support everyone. I watched Melisandre's video because I want her to gain. I watch Olivia's videos because I want her to gain. You notice when you watch TV and we have our favorite actors and then we have the ones that we can't stand? That's what it has become for Olivia. She has become someone that people can't stand. They always love to hate on someone. And it's like she's one of those actors where you're just like, and you end up hating the show. Like there is, it turned from reality TV to something that's scripted. So that's what I think happened there. And that's what it is. YouTube is basically TV. Like people log on, they tune in and they watch their favorite show, whatever it is. And they're very judgmental. But you got to be willing to accept it, take it, and see what you can change about what you do. And if it's nothing that you do, I mean, if it's something that you're doing that you feel like, oh, that is me. If I offend you, I'm sorry, but that is genuinely me, and there's nothing I can do to change me. I can only be me because everyone else is taken. So I just know how to be myself. So in my mind, it's like, okay, then you don't change what you're doing. But if you're doing that for, well, we're all doing it for the views. Let's get it right. Let's get it correct. We're all doing this for the views at the end of the day. And that's why I'm like, yo, that's why I watch everybody's shit. Like I watch it and I go through the whole, what is it? The things that pay you, the advertisement. I watch a few because I want to contribute to you. I want to help you and your family out, guys. So like I said, I love everybody and I show everybody love. And let's just squash the beef and eat chicken because it's a recession. Guys, thanks for tuning in. I think KFC won because I didn't even touch the Taco Bell. I love you. Guys, you're awesome. To all my new subscribers, thank you. Like, I truly appreciate you guys. You are, like, who's having the best week ever? MJ is. Why? Because you guys are awesome. Thank you for being so awesome. Please stay tuned. I'm, like, trying to think about other stuff to do because I like to be creative. And we, you know, us YouTubers like to put our creative stuff out there to get judged by the world and still keep moving. Thank you. You want to pray with me a little bit, a little quick prayer? God is great. God is good. Please bless everybody in the world, okay? And please help everyone financially gain something in the world. I'm not a good prayer, but, you know, for the most part, I want everyone to just have blessings upon blessings. Please, God, continue to give them what belongs to them, what they are entitled to, what they claim, what they wake up and want every day, Lord. You are awesome. I continue to worship you because you are an awesome God. Thank you. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. Bye, guys. Thanks for watching. And oh, remember, we all gotta eat, so why not eat with me? Bye.